Professor Dave here. Let's graph some lines.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We've done quite a bit of algebra up to this point by learning how to manipulate and solve different kinds of algebraic equations using a variety of techniques. But algebra isn't just about manipulating equations. We will be doing a lot of graphing as well, because graphs are visual representations of equations that help us comprehend the relationship between two variables. Let's take an incredibly simple equation, y equals x. This says that whatever x is equal to, y is equal to that too. So if we make a chart of x values and their corresponding y values, we get 0 and 0, 1 and 1, 2 and 2. This could continue to infinity in either direction. Is there some way we can draw a picture that demonstrates this relationship? Why don't we draw a grid? On this grid, which we call the coordinate plane, we can create two axes, the x-axis and the y-axis, which split the plane up into four quadrants. Those are quadrants 1, 2, 3, and 4, represented by Roman numerals. By convention, the x-axis is horizontal and the y-axis is vertical. Upon these axes, we can draw a physical representation of any algebraic relationship. For example, if each tick mark is worth 1, then we can place all of these pairs of x and y values where they belong on the coordinate plane. If x equals 0 and y equals 0, that would be this point here, where the axes cross. This is called the origin. So let's put a dot there. For 1 and 1, we need to get to an x value of 1, which is 1 to the right, and a y value of 1, which is up 1. So let's put a dot here. We can do the same for 2 and 2, 3 and 3, and so forth. Each of these points can be described with coordinates called ordered pairs. These can be represented as a pair of numbers within parentheses, separated by a comma. That means 2, 2 will correspond with this point, and we always list the x value first, followed by the y value. If we want to find 7, 4, we start at the origin and go 7 to the right, then up 4. If we want to find negative 3, negative 6, we start at the origin and go 3 to the left and 6 down, as left and down are the negative directions for x and y respectively. Now, with all these dots pertaining to our original data set, we may as well connect them, because it's not just integers that satisfy this relationship. If x is 1.59, so is y. If x is 267 125ths, so is y. So this line contains all the possible real numbers that satisfy this equation. In this way, the line represents the equation y equals x. Let's try another, y equals 2x plus 3. Again, we can make a table where we choose any numbers we like for the independent variable, x, and see what values we get for the dependent variable, y, which depends on the value of x for its own value. When x is 0, y is 3. If x is 1, y is 5. If x is 2, y is 7. So we can see the relationship between x and y begin to emerge, even just by looking at the numbers. Every time x grows by 1, y grows by 2. Because of this 2 in the equation. But this relationship is understood more effectively if we draw the graph. Here are the first three points we mentioned, with their ordered pairs listed. Remember, it's the x value first, then the y value. We connect the dots, and there is our line. Now, the interesting thing about graphing these equations is that we can use the graph to make inferences about the system, instead of having to do any math. Say we take this same equation, and we want to know the value of x when y equals 0. We can trace along this line until it crosses the x-axis, and right where it touches the x-axis is where y must equal 0. At that point, the x value is right in between negative 1 and negative 2, so it must be negative 3 halves. Of course, we can very easily do the algebra to verify this. Plug in 0 for y, subtract 3, divide by 2, and we quickly get the solution that way. But as equations get more complex, it won't be possible to do such quick math, and therefore information present on a graph that we can see visually will become more and more valuable in trying to describe algebraic systems. Also, graphing equations gives us a new and beautiful perspective on math itself. We can view y equals 2x plus 3 as simply an equation, or we can view it as the representation of a line, a genuine geometric object, determined by all the points in the xy plane that satisfy this relationship. The fact that there are many different perspectives in math is not only incredible, but also useful, as a variety of approaches will better allow us to solve a variety of problems. We will be graphing quite a bit throughout our study of math, which means we'd better understand the coordinate plane. So let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.